Let's get an update on the rescue efforts in Batanes. We have on the line Senator Richard Gordon, chairperson of the Philippine Red Cross. Good afternoon, Senator Gordon, and thanks for taking time.
Good afternoon.
Yes, sir, what do we know so far about the rescue operations? Are there actually people still being pulled out of the rubble based on the reports that you have been receiving?
We don't have any reports of people being pulled out of the rubble. I'm sorry. What we concentrated on is bringing in our people in there and bringing in our equipment, such as water purification devices, so that we could provide water and bladders to the 2,000 people that are in the plaza, and also to provide help to the hospital. We have also provided generators so that we can operate and single sidebands, as well as a satellite phone, so we can get a better hold on what is happening. In the meantime, we're preparing food, hot food, as well as canned food that you don't have to cook, so that they can immediately satisfy the hunger that is present there. We also bought tarpaulins so that they could provide temporary shelter,
right?
Because all of them cannot go back to their homes. So we have toolkits so they can build temporary homes out of the tarpaulins we're sending over.
Yes, how's the logistics going in terms of sending relief goods from mainland to Batanes, considering that the transportation is pretty much challenging?
Yes, it is, because, for example, we were supposed to send it early this morning. It did not pull through. At lunchtime, we were supposed to take off, but I think we were held back. So tomorrow is the day we'll be going to be finally able to move. We spent the whole night last night prepositioning, getting all the equipment and bringing it to Clark Field. Some have been brought to Cagayan and to Lawag just in case we can fly from there. That's the basic problem. First, you can only land in Batanes. Kind of difficult to land the C-130 in the earthquake area. It's a short runway, and so they use smaller planes. So that's the big problem right now.
Yes, we've spoken to FIVOX earlier. FIVOX said the people cannot return to their homes until the aftershocks are over. This means we need more relief goods sent to the areas. How long do you think this entire relief operation will last?
Well, the aftershocks last for sometimes years, a year, no?
Right.
But definitely they will be less and less, and it really is the trauma. So, by the way, we're also sending psychosocial support, social workers, to help the children get rid of their trauma and make a new adjustments on what is happening to their lives. So that's the key thing right now. Certainly, food, we will always buy from the local area. If it's available there, the Red Cross will provide food from the local area. But because they cannot cook, we provided them with ready-to-eat meals on cans. You just peel it off and you can eat adobo, or you can eat all kinds of other food.
Yes, Senator Gordon, a lot of people, a lot of Filipinos are most closely monitoring the situation in Batanes. A lot of them want to help. How can they do that?
Well, they can help the Red Cross by just going to chapter. I will send you the bank accounts of the Red Cross that they can help, so that we can generate. They already raised $500,000 right off the bat to take care of sending our people, and at the same time sending all the preliminary equipment, and we're hoping to raise more so that we can really make the necessary adjustments so that people will be people suffering will be alleviated faster.
All right, thanks a lot for talking to us. We know it's been a busy day for you, Senator Gordon.
It's been a busy night.